the year 1980, the first technological university was established in Nigeria. Rivers State University of Science and Technology has a staff strength of 3,000 and a population of 17,000 students. Food. Food is an edible substance consisting of nutritious components which sustains life, provides growth and health for the human body. Food vending on campus. Food vending has existed as long as Arrest UST system has existed. Food vending is referred to as street food or ready-to-eat food sold by a vendor or a hawker at a reasonable price. In order to sustain the body and generate energy, students resort to buying food from vendors on campus following the ban of food cooking in hostels. Due to the fire incident that occurred in female hostels on the February 27, 2013, the university authority made cooking in hostels prohibited, and this resulted to students patronizing more food vendors on campus than before.
It wasn't easy. It was very difficult because as of then we were cooking. But after that, after the incident, we couldn't cook again and affected us so badly that we need to buy food. And it's not healthy. I don't think it's healthy because some of the food you eat is not properly done. It's not properly cooked. Sometimes you eat, you see fly, all sorts of things, ants in the food. And so it's not healthy to the system.
Foods found on campus include roasted plantain and fish, formerly called bole, rice, soup, indomie, snacks, drinks, and various kinds of Nigerian meals. One major importance of food vending is that it makes food easier to get and cheaper for students living on campus.
How many times do you buy food?
3 times.
Like how much
in a day, I spend no less than 800, 600, depends.
And it's compulsory, you have to buy food because you can't cook.
Yes, it's very, very compulsory for all the students.
With the ban on cooking in hostels, students can get food anytime, any day, at an affordable price. Although food plays an important part in our day-to-day life, it can cause harm to the body system if contaminated.
Food vending is essential in RSUST campus, but it becomes a problem when proper hygiene is not observed. Students can eat out of hunger without being mindful of the hygienic situation of the environment and the food vendor. If proper hygiene is observed by the food vendors on campus, then there will be no problem with eating on campus.
Food vendors on campus have the problem of poor hygiene. Not all vendors are seen to observe proper hygiene. Students, academic staffs, and non-academic staffs patronize food vendors regularly.
In terms of that, I don't go place to places in the campus to eat. Rather than I have a particular place where I eat in the campus, which is Booster H. There is a woman there. She's an Ikwere woman. She comes with, she uses one V-boot C-class or so. So at least I have tested several places, even outside and here in the campus. That, yes, she has a okazi, she has a okra soup. When you test that woman okra soup, you will forget your mother's soup. You will never, yes. That woman's egusi soup is one of the egusi soup in this campus. You understand me? So that woman, she's too much. If you eat her native is one of the best. Yes, yes. Even this evening, I go there every evening because she comes in the evening. You understand me? She serves the students during evening. So I go there once evening. From any moment from 6 o'clock, she's there.
Following the increase in food vendors on campus over the years, competition now exists between every food vendor.
My food is different because I always put enough curry fish with some items. If you eat my food and you go to other places, you will know that my food is different from there. That's why when you come here, you will see people rushing, and even when you eat, you will notice that the food is different. No matter how things are very expensive, I didn't change the pattern. I'm still using the normal things I'm supposed to do to keep my customers.
Some people get attracted to certain food vendors for special reasons known to them, like how delicious the food is or the food vendor's personal hygiene.
Why do you choose? I give the other food vendors ranks. Why do you choose this exact one?
The food is well prepared. It tastes as if it's homemade. You know, it's not just colorful, it's
everybody loves good food, tasty snacks, and with the help of food vendors on campus, that urge seems to have been satisfied.
My view as a student on eating out is due to the fact, or let me say the bulk of the academic job in your hands. Because even if you have the opportunity to cook in your house, there are times that the academic load will not let you give the chance to cook in your house.
Students and people who eat on campus should be careful of how they eat, what they eat, and from whose food vendor they patronize. Food vendors should ensure that proper hygiene is observed to be able to remain in business.
Food vending on campus is provision for letting people do business as well as letting people render service. In as much as that happens, there should be an organized way in which it should be done. Because food actually is at the center of the life of the university community, both the students and the entire staff, teaching and non-teaching. And so when people are rendering food service by way of private business as a food vendors, there should be some level of regulation to ensure that the quantity and the quality of what is being served is commensurate with the expectations. Number one, when you visit a food vending point, you need to look at the environment. How neat is this environment? How neat are the people doing the service themselves? What about the point of the preparations and all that? Because what we eat tells so much about our health. Where you see an environment that does not tell of an enlightened community like this, it doesn't make well for our appropriateness. You see, I have visited a number of food vending points on campus here, and one day, even at the staff club, I make bold to say that I was teasing somebody to say, look, give me the service of branding your staff here, and they will look different and they will appear different in service promptness and all. Because you are not just eating the food, you are also relishing the environment itself. What about places where food are being served or prepared? The environment should be neat. There should be some persons with the technical know-how of what it takes to prepare food. More so here on campus that you are fortunate to have the food sciences department and the allied services. There should be regulation where inspectors, designated inspectors, should inspect both the persons doing the work, the environment where they are doing the work, and the food itself that they are serving. We eat so much of junks around, and people are in a hurry to make money. And so they can make up things that are not really good for eating, for consumption. But where there is a regulation and it is evenly done, it shouldn't be something that will be fair to vendor A and unfair to vendor B. There should be a level playing ground on which each of the groups of vendors should be assessed so that they also will be happy themselves. There should be no favoritism in it. But definitely, there should be regulation because we are in an enlightened environment. You just won't be eating as if you are by the roadside. There should be a step up in the quality of what is given here as food. And to do that, there has to be a regulation with a human face. I subscribe to overseeing what the food vendors do, for as long as it is genuinely and liberally done for the good of everyone.
Food is essential, and the people living in the university community need help. The university will continue to survive stronger and stronger than ever if healthy food is served.